And a lot of us are not showing what it is that you are to see, not to believe in me, but to help you to believe in yourself a little bit more, that you can bring something out of you. It may not be a tape, but it could be something greater than what you're looking at. Mm-hmm. And that's what we're going to have to do. We can't continue to lock up in the Congress. Just to tell you a little bit about Mr. Hanna, who I've not spoken about himself. He goes to the prisons. He does more than his share, encouraging, helping people in the physical sense. And what we're trying to do in this Congress, which you're a part of, because if we are doing the same thing, then we must be from the same Congress. In other words, we're doing things in your way that you have to do it. Your way and in your way, sister. And you have such a hard task because when I look at what our sisters have been brought to now, believing in, looking for that Prince Charming, and nobody is teaching him. And the way she tries to entice him is by taking off literally all of her clothes.
That's true.
So what we have to do now, we all have to get together. I mean, we have to work with the men. But at the same time, I want to help you to tell the sisters, get dressed. We prefer you in that manner. Yeah. Don't be so boisterous. We are looking for a queen. And if we can only do that, I'm hopeful. I'm optimistic that there will be a great change if we continue doing what we're
doing. Hold that thought. We're going to come back on the great change, Dr. Vama and Dr. Morris. We want to know what you're going to do to make this great change. Because, you know, personally, I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. In my own country, I want to end this rubbish quick. Yeah. And I hear you saying it's going to take a little while, but when you come back, I want you to tell me how we can accelerate this process and make it a little quicker. We'll be right back. Thank you very much.
My name is Ronald Thomas, and I thoroughly enjoyed watching JCN. I can't think of a finer station to watch than JCN. It's been a long
time coming, but I know. Oh man, I'm looking at this table, and I'm just in awe. But Dr. Vama, let me get back to you. You just before we took the break, you were just developing, Brother Ali had just touched on a very important point to you, and really, I want to endorse everything he said to you. But in terms of accelerating this thing now, how are we going to, what can we do as an organization, the Bahamas Pan-African National Congress, besides programs like this? What else can we do to accelerate the pace of reawakening of our people? Because I think your point is that our people have gone to sleep. Both you and Dr. Morris are saying, and they've sold it, but we've been putting it in a different context. We're saying they've given away this rich culture, and they've embraced something that really is a second-hand culture that really belongs to you in the first place. Mm-hmm. And Brother Ali has been saying this for the past two shows, you know, and basically, what we have in Christianity as it's posed today is misleading the people. How do you feel in terms of spirituality, the context of the Bible? How does the Bible and the fairy come fit within this context of a fairy tale?
Well, first of all, what we say, and then I'll let Sister Morris jump right in, Dr. Morris, but what we want everyone to understand, we're not attacking Christianity. We're not attacking Judaism. We're not attacking Islam. Mm-hmm. What we are attacking is the mentality as these religions were being introduced to our people. We know that real Christianity begins in Africa. People say, what are you talking about? There's no way. Mm-hmm. But yet, as a Christian, I was taught my whole life that when Jesus was a boy, his life was in danger. The angel told Joseph, take Mary the boy, go to Egypt. Mm-hmm. So if they were going to Egypt to hide there till Herod was gone, then Egypt had this child, this Messiah, this Christ, this Savior, this chosen child living amongst us in Africa. Because mm-hmm. Egypt was not just the region called Africa, mm-hmm. Egypt today, but the whole continent, Tamere. Mm-hmm. So he lived there, mm-hmm. which means he learned amongst us, mm-hmm. which means he was taught our ideologies, mm-hmm. our approaches towards life, so much so that when he returned back to Jerusalem amongst these scribes and Pharisees and Sanhedrins, etc., he was teaching something that threatened them.
They didn't know about
that. Scared them to their foundation. And what was that? He was teaching, they said, even in the Bible, and I learned this in the book of John, that he said, why do you seek to stone me? Why do you want to kill me? He said, for a good work we stone you not, for because you being a man maketh yourself a god. And he said, well, is it not written in your law, I say you are gods? So the problem they were having was that he was bringing to the attention of the masses the power of divinity within them. Mm-hmm. And that threatens the establishment.
That's right.
Where they're saying, put your faith in me and I'll get you to God. He was saying, no, you are God and children of the Most High. Mm-hmm. And that means that the divine power of God, Jehovah, Allah, Adonai, Yahweh,
so many different names
power are within us.
Yes, my
but
God.
To get when you say, but well, where does it, how do we accelerate it? We've got to stop teaching our children these wrong fairy tales. Where do most of us develop our bad eating habits from? Mm-hmm. I'm overweight. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to lose weight. My cholesterol's high. Mm-hmm. I go to the doctor. Mm-hmm. The doctor runs these tests. He comes back, he says, well, Mr. Varma, cholesterol's high, high blood pressure. You have to stop eating red meats. It's not really good for you. And you have to give up the pork. Someone else goes into the hospital.
Yeah.
And they say, Mrs. Morris, we ran your blood work and you have diabetes. You have to give up the red meat and you have to give up the pork. Mm-hmm. Someone else goes in and they have another ailment. The doctor says, well, you have to give up the red meat. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You have to give. So now, are we saying don't eat red meat? No, I'm not telling you what to eat. What we are saying is, why does it always take us getting ill, going to the doctor, to now find out that the foods that we've been given are not good for us? Mm-hmm. Well, if I'm reading my child, this little piggy went to market, and this little piggy went to such and such, and this little piggy went to this little piggy went all the way home. Or I'm reading to my child, once upon a time, there were three little piggies, and one little pig built his house out of straw. I'm putting in the minds of the children that this creature that's going to eventually make me sick, not because of religion, not because of Judaism saying you shouldn't eat it, not because of Islam saying you shouldn't eat it. We as ancient Tamarian people said, don't eat that because you are what you eat. If you continue to eat things that your body cannot digest and process, then the mind, the brain uses the blood, the fresh blood cells to give it life, to give it nutrients, to make you think outside the box. Mm-hmm. So we can accelerate it by focusing on the fairy tales, focusing on the diets, focusing on what we're giving our children physically to eat, spiritually to embrace, mentally to accept, and emotionally to be on this emotional roller coaster. Mm-hmm. You know, as Dr. Morris was saying, go ahead.
That also comes in when we're speaking about these fairy tales. Excuse me. When you speak about these fairy tales, it creates a false sense of reality. Mm-hmm. It creates these false expectations and the sense of entitlement. Mm-hmm. This sense that I really don't have to really do anything, but I'm going to receive the world. Mm-hmm. This man is going to come, and they always say the saying, give you the moon and the stars.
Yeah.
As if it was his to give in the first place.
Yeah.
But
we're
looking for to get something for nothing. Mm-hmm. We've become, when you said how are we going to speed this up, we've become complacent because we've received through these fairy tales, which start from fairy tales and go to the movies, go to the daytime soap operas, the nighttime soap operas, the video games, and we can go on and on and on. And this creates a sense that I can just sit here and everything is going to be given to me. Mm-hmm. And so our children are learning this mentality along with the false expectations. Mm-hmm. When we were younger, if you went to school every day, you went to school every day. You were supposed to go to school to learn. Mm-hmm. Now we have a perfect attendance award. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Why are you getting an award for being at school? You're supposed to be at school.
Yeah.
Now when we go at the end of the year, everybody's getting a prize. Yeah. When we were younger, those who excelled got the prize, and that was the incentive for those that fell short to work harder next year in order to receive that prize. Mm-hmm. But it seems like society is going backwards, and that's why, because we have these expectations, and then we don't reach them, we go into the state of depression.